Welcome to Children's Ministry at the Fort Bend Church. I'm Miss Deidre. It's prayer time. Let us pray. Dear God, please hear our prayer. We praise your holy name. We thank you for your love. We thank you, God, for Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the Bible and our church. We thank you for our pastor and our parents. We thank you for our teachers and our friends. We love you, God, our Father. Dear God, help us obey you and make you smile. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. It's time for praise and worship. Let's stand and sing, "This Is the Day."
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice.
In today's Bible story, John's vision of Jesus, a man named John was sent to a small island as punishment for telling others about Jesus. While John was there on that island, Jesus appeared to him. Jesus spoke to him and said, "I am the first and the last." The story point for today's Bible story is Jesus showed himself to John. Watch our Bible story to learn more about what happened.
Hi friends, Megan here, and this is Jesse.
Hi everyone. Megan, guess who I saw at the park today?
Who did you see?
I saw my friend, Mateo. He used to be in my karate class a long time ago, but he stopped coming.
Oh, well that's too bad. But I'm so glad you got to see him today.
Me too. We got to play at the park while our moms talked. We had so much fun climbing the monkey bars together today. Man, I missed him.
In today's Bible story, John, one of Jesus' disciples, saw someone he hadn't seen in a long time.
He did? Was it someone he used to do karate with?
No, he saw Jesus. The last time John saw Jesus, Jesus was going back to heaven to be with his Father. But many years later, Jesus appeared to John in a vision. Listen to the story. Like many people who believed in Jesus, John was hurt and hated because he told people about Jesus. The leader of Rome punished John by sending him to a small island. When John was on the island, he had a vision. A vision is like a dream, but John was awake. John heard a loud voice like a trumpet. The voice said, "Write on a scroll what you see. Then send the message to the seven churches in Ephesus, Smyrna, Pergamum, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea." John turned around and saw seven golden lampstands. Then he saw who had spoken to him. It was Jesus. Jesus was wearing a long robe with a gold sash wrapped around his chest. He had seven stars in his right hand. When John saw Jesus, he fell down at Jesus' feet. Jesus put his hand on John and said, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. I was dead, but look, I am alive forever and ever." Jesus said that the seven lampstands were the seven churches. He told John to write about everything he had seen. Jesus showed himself to John. Jesus said that he is the first and the last, the living one. While Jesus was on earth, he won the fight against sin and death by dying on the cross and coming back to life. Everyone who trusts in Jesus will live with him forever.
After Jesus showed himself in a vision to John, one of his disciples, John was living on an island as punishment for telling people about Jesus. John was afraid when he saw Jesus, but he told him, "Do not fear." Jesus also told him that he was the first and the last and that he lives forever. While he was on earth, Jesus won the fight against sin and death by dying on the cross and coming back to life. Jesus also told John to write on a scroll all that he had seen. Our new key passage was also written by the disciple John. It is found in the book of Revelation, verse 11. It is found in Revelation chapter 11. Jesus told John to write down all that he saw. Our key passage tells us that when Jesus returns, he will set up his kingdom on earth and will reign forever. I want you to repeat the new key passage after me. The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and his Christ, and he will reign forever and ever. Revelation chapter 11, verse 15. Now let's sing the key passage song, "The Kingdom of the World," and the theme song, "All Hail the Power."
Kingdom of the world.
hope you enjoy singing the key passage song as much as I do, because it's a great way to help us remember our key passage. Our new big picture question asks, what is the hope of the church? The answer says, the church looks forward to Jesus' return when he will make all things new. Jesus said that he is coming back soon. When Jesus comes back, everyone who trusts in him will be with him forever. God will undo every bad thing, no more death, pain, or tears. Jesus is making all things new. Missionaries around the world are teaching the hope of Jesus from the Bible. Later in our Missions Moment video, you will meet a missionary family who is bringing hope to the people who live in a country called Uganda, which is in Africa. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Our gospel gems for today's Bible story remind us that John saw a vision of Jesus. Jesus told John to write down a special message, and Jesus is alive forever. After the Missions Moment video, work on your activity page with a parent. This week, I want you to pray for the Singerman family. Remember to subscribe to the Fort Bend Church YouTube channel. Like and share this week's video. Bye. See you next time.
My name is Micah.
My name is Josiah.
My name is Rachel.
I'm Victoria.
I'm Kevin, and we serve here in northern Uganda with Sudanese refugees. My call to mission started when I was very young. In fact, I was on the mission field as a kid with my parents, who are missionaries in West Africa. So it's really cool to be back in a place that is like the place I grew up. The culture is similar in some ways, although the language is completely different.
When I was 13 years old, my sister gave me a book that had stories about martyrs. While reading it, I realized that God really exists and that I needed to submit my life to Jesus. At that time, God also gave me a huge desire to go and share the gospel with people who had no access to it and to go where others may not be willing to go.
My wife and I have a desire to serve God wherever he would take us. And that started back in the States, and now he has moved us here to Uganda, but we continue to look for ways to serve God no matter where he would take us. And I have ants crawling all over my feet right now. Now we are serving over 1.5 million refugees who have found safety here within the Ugandan borders. Our team is working to bring hope, encouragement, and empowerment to those who are in these refugee settlements. It is a hard life for them. Many of them are the only people left in their families. And still, they are having a hard time making a living and even finding a way to survive in these camps. But many are coming to faith in Christ and finding ways to be involved in ministry. A big part of what we do here is training people to be effective in ministry, to make healthy churches, to help them understand what it means to do ministry and disciple other people. And this is very exciting, because then they will go back home eventually and take the same training, the same things, and teach others there in their homeland.
Our ministry is very diverse. Alongside biblical training, we do humanitarian work, and that takes many different forms. We partner with BGR in repairing wells and building vulnerable houses for people who cannot do it themselves. We also do English as a second language, which gives us an opportunity to help people learn English as well as giving them the gospel and learning Bible stories. Trauma healing is one of the biggest needs in the camps, and that's something now that we're able to provide. Through the trauma healing classes, we've been able to disciple people in how to share their faith. Other people have been coming to know Jesus as Lord and Savior. And the gospel is being spread throughout the camps by those who live there and know the culture and understand their neighbors.
Our team has been learning Sudanese Arabic, which is a difficult task, but now we're seeing some of the fruit of our labor. We're able to tell Bible stories in the language and are able to go deeper into spiritual conversation because of the work that we've put into it.
Thank you so much for praying for us.
We could not do this without your prayers.